take a step back, cause it's Ellie's setback. I'm here shooting another episode of the Robert Garcia reality show. We're in the van heading to Riverside, California. Robert, you just finished training Marcos Maidana in the morning.
Yeah.
And now it takes me 3 hours from Oxnard to Riverside.
Nah, it's an hour and a half, bro.
Well, that's quate driving.
Quate driving.
It's an hour and a half.
The reason I stopped is your speed, 80, speed level 65, but I see your license.
You know what, sir? I was in a hurry today because we had the trainers, we're going to Riverside. Okay. I forgot my wallet, sir.
So we're here on the way to Riverside, California. We just got pulled over by the CHP. Robert, CHP, big fans of boxing.
We got lucky, man. Ellie.
Fuck.
Well, they got lucky. We got lucky because you told him you give away toys.
I give away toys with the CHP. No, that's the Marines.
But that's what he said. But that's what you were saying. That was cool. We got away with it,
man.
And then you tell him, you know, Manny Pacquiao. We got Brandon Reels who's fighting Manny Pacquiao.
Hey, CHP are going for Reels.
Yeah, they are.
That's awesome, man. We got away with it. Quate.
It doesn't happen every day, Quate.
No fucking driver license, warrant for his arrest. Everything, even a warrant. And we still got away with it.
Still got away.
Fuck, and he was going, what, like 120?
Yeah.
But it's... What I'm gonna say, Robert, it's never a boring day. Yo, that's reality right there, huh? I'm gonna train Mikey for his big fight against Juanma Lopez.
And then tonight, after training, we go to the airport.
Press conference tomorrow.
Press conference tomorrow.
So what do you say about the big story in the news today, Robert?
What is
it? Arrested a guy in Cleveland, last name Castro. 10 years ago, he kidnapped at least 3 women and kept them in his house like prisoners, kidded for 10 years. That he said he has sexual problems, he has other issues, and... It's crazy that how could the neighbors not realize what's going on all these years?
Yeah.
Could this happen in Oxnard if someone kidnapped
Probably
people?
Not, because there's so many people living in every house. Fucking, they got people living in the backyards, under
no
the
room.
House.
There's no room.
Under
no
the
room.
Trailer park.
It couldn't happen?
No room. No room.
Not only that.
You know where they do have room? Fucking Tony Telestory's neighborhood.
Yeah, exactly.
His neighborhood.
Yeah, but those people don't even jaywalk.
That fucker lives in the best neighborhoods in Oxnard, man.
Yeah, the cemetery.
Telestory.
Yeah, but also you have to realize that if something happens in Oxnard, within 2 minutes, Pelau knows about it. It's true.
Yeah, Pelau and fucking Henry.
Henry, yeah.
Fucking, no, what's his name? Yeah, Henry.
It would be.
Pelau knows about it in 2 minutes.
Yeah, within 2 minutes, it would be all over. It's a done deal. That's why when they said that Sergio Martinez's car was defaced and
Pelau didn't know, that means it didn't happen.
Didn't happen. It may have been for TV.
Yep.
So what do you do on the ride every day when you do this training camp?
When we're with the guys and, you know, we talk and we chill and listen.
You talked to Brandon today. He seemed very happy.
Oh, he's excited.
What do you say about his fight?
He wants to win this fight, man. He's going to win this fight. He's been watching, I told you, I got him Fernando Vargas fights.
Yeah.
When he fought Jordy Boy Campos, when he fought Raul Marquez, and when he fought Ike Corte.
Mm-hmm.
And he loves it. He loves it. He says... You know, he was a fucking beast, but he was also smart in the ring.
Yeah.
And you know, this is 10, 12 years ago that we're talking about. But those that remember, Fernando was before he lost to Trinidad, and he got knocked out and everything. He was a fucking badass motherfucker. So he's been watching those fights, and we're now, you know, we're gonna try to get a little bit of that when he's fighting. He wants my dad to help out, so I think we're gonna maybe use my dad, or at least just by my dad giving me advice, because my dad, he's not gonna be driving back and forth. He can't, but at least giving me advice. I'm already talking to him. He's already, you know, telling me how to start working with Brandon, and we're gonna start. We're gonna start soon.
Your dad, Robert, is very, very underrated. When people mention the best trainers in boxing, they seem to forget what he's done with you, from scratch to world champion. Fernando, scratch to world champion. Mikey, scratch world champion. With all the respect to Freddie Roach, who's achieved a lot in boxing, he's never taken a kid from 6 years old to a title, ever.
I agree.
So,
I agree, but you know, it's because he's the type that's just been them. He doesn't go around. He never won like press conference. He never liked being mentioned. You know,
he doesn't seem to get fame.
Look, there's been great trainers from Mexico. My dad's one of them, I could say. Nacho Bernstein, back in the days, I remember, Julio Hernandez, and my dad has mentioned so many great trainers. And believe it or not, there is a lot of racism and stuff like that. When I went to the awards last month in New York, mm-hmm. they gave us a booklet.
A nice bowl, good for popcorn.
nice book with all the information of all the years, every from, you know, so many years ago that they started doing Fighter of the Year, Trainer of the Year, and all that. There's never been a Mexican Trainer of the Year.
You're the first one?
Wow.
Never been a Mexican American Trainer of the Year.
Can I explain to you why?
I'm the first one.
I'm gonna tell you why.
I'm the first one, and I'm the youngest one too.
Okay, you know who votes for Trainer of the Year?
What?
Who? The reporters.
Yes.
80% of them.
Yes.
Let's be realistic. They're all white.
Yes.
So what do you expect? I mean,
you know what?
I'm not saying that they're racist.
We recorded it.
Yeah.
Because, you know, because the one that gave me my award mm-hmm. was Errol Letterman.
Yeah.
And he's, you know, he's always been really nice to me.
Yeah.
Very cool to me. And he remembers when I was fighting. He says, you know, he's always told me, I remember when you were fighting on HBO pay-per-view, on HBO cards, and now you're training fighters on HBO. Now you're Trainer of the Year.
So,
he gave a nice speech. He mentioned every single fighter that I've worked for, from Mia St. John to Joan Guzman. He mentioned everybody. He did his homework, all right? You know, he made a little joke. He brought up, he came in and, you know, brought up, you know, he says, I know what Robert's fighters always win. He came out with some gauze, some tape, and then a horseshoe, and, you know. So he just made it
fun. But doesn't he know you weren't even with Margarito?
He didn't even try to say that. It was a
joke.
Because he didn't even mention Margarito's name. He's the only fighter that he didn't mention. But he mentioned everybody else from, like I'm telling you, Joan Guzman, who I only worked with for two fights. He mentioned Mia St. John, who very few people even know that I worked with her. Stevie Lueva, he mentioned,
really?
You know what I mean? Yeah. So he's saying all that and everything. And then when they call me over and everything, and I have to thank all those people that have helped me, that have been behind me, all my fighters and everything. Going through that, I'm like, damn, you know, no Mexicans have ever won. They've been great Mexican champions, you know. Never. The only Mexican fighter that's ever won Fighter of the Year, Julio Cesar Chavez. And Oscar De La Hoya, who's Mexican-American. Those are the only two Mexican fighters that have ever won Fighter of the Year. And tell me, how many great, great fucking fighters Mexico has...
What do you mean? They kept boxing alive when it faded out over here. The fighters, look at Julio Cesar Chavez Jr., look at Canelo, look at Marquez. Marquez should have gotten Fighter of the Year with his career.
Yeah, and he hasn't got one.
By the way, I love the Harold Letterman in the Six Flag commercials.
You know, it's just different, you know, and it's just, like I'm telling you, racism, whatever, you know, all the reporters. So when I'm up there, Ellie, I thank my team. I mentioned to everybody, and I have it on tape. I haven't even seen it, but I have it on my phone. Look, so I go out there and I thank all my fans. So whatever.
Right.
So I want to thank because one reporter that had my back all this time. Answer this card and see what it is. It's unavailable. He told me, Robert, you should have got it last year too. You got it this year, good, congratulations. But it was yours last year. And he told me how things happened, politics, blah, blah. And they told me why I didn't get it and all this shit. 2011, right?
Yeah.
Whatever. So then I go up there and I say, you know, thanks to all those reporters. that believe in me. Mm-hmm. And I also want to thank those who don't believe in me, but had no other fucking choice, because it wasn't even close.
Yeah.
Or else they would pick somebody else. Right. Believe me, they would pick somebody else, and they would have.
But they couldn't.
They couldn't, because I gave them no fucking choice. And Paulie was there, and they laughed, because they knew I was telling the truth, right?
Yeah.
They don't want a Mexican winning those awards.
Canada. I don't know why. Why would they be racism?
PeaceReporting.com. I'm back reporting.